Just have a look at the question behind you. If you are from Indian education system, this will give you some flashbacks. This is a question from Joint Entrance Examination, JEE, one of the toughest exams in the planet. And to solve this question, you need to understand multiple concepts of physics, advanced calculus, and you have to do those all things in a short bit of time. A brilliant student might take 10 to 15 minutes to solve, to crack this question. Now, let's have a look at this. See, the question which would take a human mind 10 minutes or 15 minutes to solve can be solved by a machine in less than 10 seconds now. Quite impressive, right? Also a little bit scary. It's not any party trick. It's not any cool trick anymore. And this is a fundamental shift which is happening in our world. And with this, I just wanted to tell you a personal story which has been bothering me for some time. Some weeks back, I conducted an online test to a group of really brilliant students. They have really proven academic track record. And when the results came, I felt like something was a little off. Even with their brilliance, the average of the exam looked like it's a bit too high. So we did something radical. We went ahead and we interviewed each one of them. And a very shocking thing which happened was most of the students admitted that they have cheated in the exam. Not because they didn't know how to solve the problem, not because they are bad kids or lazy. One of the students told me, "Sir, I knew how to solve this problem, but my mind just told me to use the Google lens so that it's just too easy." This is one of the dangers which is lying ahead of us. And this is the first symptom of a condition I call intellectual obesity. Now, we all know what physical obesity is about, right? Physical obesity, it has two factors to contribute to it. We are living in a world of abundance. We are consuming a lot of junk food, which is of high calories, but very low nutrition because it's just so satisfying to our mind. Plus the second factor is that we are lazy to do any kind of physical activity or exercise. And because of these two things, we have already entered an era of an obesity epidemic. Now, let's apply the same thing to our mind. We are increasingly living in a digital world. When we get a little bit time, we go to Instagram or YouTube and watch reels or shorts, which are actually very cheap, but very satisfying, of no intellectual values. Let me ask you a question. I'll give you two choices. You either have an option to watch 100 short videos continuously for 1 hour of time, or you have an option to do a math problem for 5 minutes. Which one will you choose? Even the most brilliant among you might choose, including me, to choose the short videos. Why? The reason is that it's actually very easy to do that. Our brain always chooses the convenient thing to do. It always works very efficiently. So, now think about AI entering this scene. And now we are on steroids, right? We always want that dopamine hit. Plus, all our thinking has been also outsourced now. The struggle of forming an argument, the effort of learning something new, or the trial and error of solving a problem, everything we are outsourcing to artificial intelligence. And what happens? We are entering the world of intellectual obesity, where we really have all the answers within us, but without any real thoughts. Now, you can just ask that, isn't just like a calculator? Isn't it just another tool that we have been using over the history? Yes, we use tools for cognitive offloading. which means that we take down notes so that we don't have to memorize things. We use calculators so that it can do the complex mathematics and we can use our minds or brains to do something more important. And that is called cognitive offloading. But right now, we are actually offloading the outsourcing the thinking process itself. Imagine an architect solve physics and math problems by the design is done inside the architect's mind. But what is happening now? We are outsourcing the whole thinking process to artificial intelligence. And this might have serious consequences going forward. And right now, we have proof for that too. Couple of weeks ago, a research was published by MIT. What they did was something interesting. They chose three groups of people and asked them to write essays. The first group, they have to write it their own using their brain only. The second group, they were allowed to use the Google search. And the third group, they were allowed to use ChatGPT as a writing assistant. Now, all their brains were connected to sensors with EEG monitoring. And something shocking was happening. The people who were writing using ChatGPT, they had the lowest brain activity. The parts of brain which handles focus, memory formation, and critical thinking was kind of switched off. Their brain moved from an actively thinking to passive standby mode. And this is something which we should be concerned of. Because as neuroscientists tells us, our brain has an amazing property. It's called neuroplasticity. We either use it or we lose it. Our brains are like our muscles. Once you actively engage your muscles, you get physically fit. If similarly, to get intellectually fit, your brain has to be working. Your brain has to go through mental struggle. And that mental struggle is the thing which is actually contributing to your mental fitness, to the development of your brain. In the AI era, we are actually outsourcing the whole thinking process to an AI system or machine. That's why these are a high-stake thing for our children for future. Think of us adults. We have actually grown in an era where most of these tools didn't exist. We have grown our intellectual capability in a hard way. But what's going to happen to our kids? This is of concern to us. Because the kids use these AI tools as crutches. Imagine a drug being rolled out to a market. Before a drug rolls out to a market, it goes through experimentation in lab rats. Then there are different phases of clinical trials, phase 1, 2, 3, etc. And after that only, a drug is rolled out to market. Now, one of the most mind-altering, powerful tools that humans have ever created has been rolled out to our next generation without any public debate or any studies on long-term effects of it. Basically, all the kids we have are the AI lab rats, and we should be concerned about this. Now, what will happen to our kids going forward is a serious question. We often say that people with AI will replace people without it. That might be true for us, the adult generation, but things might be different for the next generation. Because there is every chance that these same AI systems may hamper the brain development of a developing kid. We might have two categories of citizens, one who have used these AI tools to boost their thinking capabilities, and the other who has been completely dependent on these AI systems, and they might be deprived of thinking. And this is a scary problem to have. Because as AI replaces all the routine tasks we have, the human should be focusing on skills that machine can't replace. Innovative thinking, critical analysis, and creativity. But we are at risk of raising a generation who have not built their skills. because these are the very skills that intellectual obesity attacks. This might create problems in future. The next generation of engineers, doctors, teachers, lawyers may be highly productive, but they might be missing the mental muscles to build the next big thing. Who will make the next great discovery if the people are deprived of thinking? Then what's the solution? Can we ban AI? No, definitely not. It's not the solution. We have to do something harder. We have to reimagine the education system we have. Imagine a math teacher telling you, you can use AI to solve this problem, but find me three different ways to solve this problem and tell me which is the most elegant one and why. Imagine a history teacher giving a ChatGPT generated essay to students and telling them to find faults in it, find biases in the article, find the missing points in the article, ask them to critically analyze that. We are entering an era where we should not be valuing answers, but we should be valuing the process on how we get there. Because answers are easy to come by in this era, and what matters is the thought process behind it. The reward should be given to the thought process that a student exhibits. We should make our children increasingly AI literate, not just to teach them nuances of machine learning or deep learning, but they should be able to use these AI tools in an ethical and responsible way. Just like a physical training period we have often a week in every school, we should have intellectual training sessions where the students are given open-ended problems and puzzles to solve with just a paper and pen in hand. The story of humanity is the story of our tools too. As much as we have shaped the tools have shaped us too. AI is the most powerful tool that we have ever created. We have an opportunity to be an incredible partner, or it has the capability to destroy our cognitive development. The choice is ours. Let me leave you with one thought. The greatest threat of AI is not that AI will start thinking like us, but the greatest threat is that we will start thinking like AI. Easy, fast way, right? Which is actually unchallenged and obedient. We should give our children a chance to build their intellectual faculty before these AI tools take over their minds. Let's teach them the struggle they should have. Let's teach them doing hard things is actually making them stronger. In this era of endlessly easy answers, let's all choose to be intellectually fit. Thank you.